You know, they say that some of the best places in the States to watch sports is in Missouri, Kansas City especially. I can imagine what it was like for the inaugural seasons of the Kansas City Blades hockey team in the early 1990s when they were in the IHL. Boys, their fan base was tremendous, really respected and looked up to the side. A lot of great players skated there. And for a lot of people, the franchise is heavily missed. Now, the Kansas City Blades, again, were a minor pro hockey team in the International Hockey League who played at the venerable Kemper Arena. Now, Russ and Diane Parker had bought the dormant Toledo Gold Diggers and moved them to Kansas City in 1990. Russ Parker conducted a contest to name the team and the fan chose the name Jazz. However, because the NBA's Utah Jazz were already using that name, Parker decided to use the second most popular name, Blades. George Brett was one of a number of local athletes that had submitted the name Blades during the naming contest. Coincidentally, that was also the name of the IHL franchise that preceded the Gold Diggers in Toledo. Now, for the 91 season, the Blades were an independent team. From 91 to 96, they were the primary affiliate of the San Jose Sharks. Coincidentally, the Blades moniker was the first place finisher for the Sharks' named team contest, but the ownership feared negative connotations and went with Sharks instead. The Sharks and Blades entered an association in the summer of 96, leaving the Blades as an independent team once again. This coincided with the sale of the team to billionaire Richard DeVos, who also owned stakes in the Grand Rapids Griffins and the Orlando Solar Bears. One of the changes was an overhaul of the team logos and uniforms that was unveiled on July 9, 98. The new logo was created by Sean Michael Edwards Design of New York City. For the final season, the Blades became the primary affiliate of the Vancouver Canucks. The affiliation agreement was for two seasons, but the Blades and the entire IHL ceased operations 1 year into the partnership. The Blades' best season was in 92 when they won the Turner Cup in only their second season under the coaching of Kevin Constantine. The Blades advanced to the Turner Cup Finals again in 95, only to lose in four straight games to the Denver Grizzlies. Head coaches for the team included Doug Soltart, Kevin Constantine, Jen Wiley, Vasily Tikhonov, Don Jackson, Paul McLean, and Stan Schmeel. Now, during the 2000 season, rumors became reality as DeVos attempted to move the Blades franchise to Oklahoma City. Faithful fans held a Save the Blades rally to persuade local government to keep the team in Kansas City. In the end, the team would not move to Oklahoma City due to disputes between the league and both cities. By this point, the DeVos family was no longer welcomed by Blades fans and was often booed under rare appearances in Kansas City. So much for Amway. Now, the effort to save the franchise proved to be a dead letter. Due to financial troubles, the IHL ceased operation in summer 2001. Surviving IHL teams were admitted in the AHL for the 2002 season, but because of league rules, owners could only control one team. DeVos chose to move the Griffins to the IHL since they were based in his family's hometown of Grand Rapids, and he folded the Solar Bears and the Blades. Now, the Kansas City Outlaws of the United Hockey League played in the Kemper Arena for the 2005 season before they folded. They've had the Kansas City Mavericks of the ECHL now play in the Silverstein Eye Center's arena in nearby Independence. But in 2007, the Sprint Center opened in downtown Kansas City. It was built specifically to attract an NHL or NBA team. Now, several NHL exhibition games have also been held in Kansas City since the demise of the Blades. The St. Louis Blues have played four exhibition games in Kansas City, including games at the Kemper Arena in 03 and 05, and games at the Sprint Center in 08, 14, and 16. Now, various NHL alumni, including the great Link Gates, have been affiliated with or played there. Top alumni have included Brian Allen, Jean-Sébastien Aubin, Shane Donovan, Andrew Ference, Wayne Flaherty, Claude Julien, Arthur Zerbe, Steve Correa, Darren Kimball, Victor Kozlov, Jim Kite, Patrick Lalime, Jeff McLean, David Ling, Kip Miller, Jeff Rogers, Sanders Olzelnish, Mike Pavanka, Mike Ratchie, Jeff Sargent, Brent Sopel, Ray Whitney, and of course, Dodie Wood. Now, for me, the best promotion, which I mentioned in one of my old Sports File columns years ago, was something called Tootless Night. Now, the Tootless Night promotion got international publicity, as on April 1799, fans with missing teeth received free admission as part of the promotion. How many people with missing teeth showed up, ladies and gentlemen? Take a wild guess. Was it 100, 200? 269 fans with missing teeth received free admission. Now, did you have a dentist here to check? Was it a visual thing? All I know, ladies and gentlemen, at least half of the players that probably played that game had missing teeth. So again, whatever works in small town. We know how baseball promotions are weird in small town USA. But I'd like to know if there was a big group shot of the 269 missing teeth people. Did they have their own section? Ladies and gentlemen, if you like what we're doing here with our profiles on respected and beloved AHL, IHL, minor pro teams, let us know with a like, comment, and subscribe. And check out YouTube. There's various stories on the blades that are out there. And don't forget, keep your stick in the ice. Bye.